If you want a career in broadcasting or film, Premiere is the tool for you. But if you want to record your screen, edit a video, or show someone how to do something, Camtasia has everything you need all in one piece of software. Hi, I'm Andy from TechSmith, where we help you show what you know. Today, we're gonna look at how Camtasia's all-in-one screen recorder and video editor stacks up against Adobe Premiere Pro. Make sure to subscribe to our channel to keep getting helpful video content and click the bell to be notified as soon as it's available. First, we're gonna open both programs and compare the initial experience. Let's do a screen recording of our website as if we were creating a tutorial on how to navigate it. We need to record our screen, microphone, and some webcam footage and edit it all together. Premiere Pro may be the standard for professional video editors, but it can be super daunting for people who are new to video creation. When you open Premiere Pro, you get a welcome window where you can choose from your recent projects or create a new one. As soon as we open up this start menu, however, the sheer volume of settings and other options feels overwhelming. For newer video creators, a lot of these settings or terms may be unfamiliar, and that can be an obstacle to getting started on your project. Now, we need to record our screen for this project. Premiere Pro doesn't have a built-in screen recorder, so you'll have to use a third-party screen capture software. In this video, we'll be demonstrating with OBS Studio's free screen recorder. OBS records them as a single track, so whatever dimensions and orientation you have your webcam set for in the screen recording will be stuck that way when it comes time to edit. Now let's try to accomplish the same task using Camtasia. In Camtasia, the welcome window kicks us right off with recent projects, as well as a couple of other options. Do you want a new project? A project from one of Camtasia's easy-to-use templates? New recording? No technical knowledge necessary. Just select the option that fits your current needs, and Camtasia will take care of the rest. For our project, I'll click New Recording. Camtasia offers many options beyond what you can do with OBS. You can select the display size of the windows you'd like to record, the dimensions of your webcam recording, the volume of your microphone, as well as your computer audio input. Toggle any of these settings on and off if you don't need to use them all at the same time, and then hit the Start Recording button, which will initiate the countdown to begin your screen recording. When we're done recording, just open up the recorder tool and select Stop Recording. Unlike OBS, with Camtasia, the webcam and screen recording are automatically separated into different tracks so you can edit them individually. This provides you with the option to edit the position and size of the webcam on your screen, and even remove it altogether if there are certain parts of the recording where you want the entire screen visible. Your microphone and/or system audio are also added to separate tracks and can be edited individually. So we have our recording and we're ready to edit. We made some mistakes that need to be cut, and we want to add some text and animations. Let's look at our options in each program. In Premiere, we have the Captions and Graphics panel, where all of your, you guessed it, captions and graphics are located. They have a few templates available for you to use when it comes to text titles and graphics. However, the options overall are fairly limited, and if we want to edit or animate these, it can be a bit of a challenge without prior experience. Anytime you want to animate anything in Premiere, you have to use the keyframe editing system. If you aren't familiar with this system, then diving right into animations can be quite the challenge. With keyframes, anytime you want your graphic or text to move position or change in some way over a period of time, you place keyframes along the timeline to mark each change or movement. For example, if we want our text title to drop down into position letter by letter from the top of our screen, we would have to place each letter of our title above the canvas, mark a keyframe for each as their starting point, then move each of them down to their respective ending position, and mark down the keyframes on the timeline once again to close out the animation. And that's just the most basic method in which to animate keyframes. The same thing goes for any visual effects you'd like to apply to your video, as they also operate solely on the keyframe editing system within Premiere Pro. In addition, anything beyond simple motion animations and basic video effects are going to require the use of Adobe After Effects, as Premiere's options for animations and graphics are kind of limited. Unfortunately, this means learning an entirely new, arguably more challenging software just to accomplish something slightly more visually engaging than text moving across your screen. In Camtasia, animations and graphics are easily located in the Annotations, Behaviors, and Animations tab. Select the Annotations tab for a selection of preset text and callout options, which you can simply click and drag onto the timeline to apply. To alter them, double-click the letters on the canvas, and you're free to edit text as needed. Creating text movement is just as easy, no keyframes necessary. Just go to the Behaviors tab and select whichever preset animation fits your needs. If you're not sure which animation is the right one, don't worry, as every animation in Camtasia comes with a quick visual preview of what they do, so you don't have to waste time guessing or experimenting with every option just to find the one you're looking for. In Premiere, to make our text fall from the top of the screen into position, we had to go keyframe by keyframe on every single letter. With Camtasia, all you have to do is select the jump and fall animation, clicking and dragging it onto the title that we've set up in the timeline. You can easily adjust the speed and timing of the animation as well. Camtasia also offers a selection of cursor effects that you can add to your screen recording as long as it was recorded in Camtasia. This includes cursor smoothing, which smooths out any choppy motions that might have occurred while recording your screen. You can add a magnify or highlight to your cursor. If you want to add a simple animation that occurs when you click your cursor on the screen recording, Camtasia can do that as well. Under cursor effects, you have the option of adding rings that expand outward, or ripples to your mouse clicks, and more. All of these effects can be further customized under the properties window as well. When it comes time to export your video, Premiere Pro offers a massive scope of options for presets as well as deeper customizable options. However, that's just what it is. Massive! As you can see from the multi-paneled export window, the sheer amount of technical knowledge required just to export your video is, well, a lot. Compare that to Camtasia's export dropdown, which is condensed to a simple list, whether creating a local file on your hard drive or on a platform like YouTube, Vimeo, Google Drive, etc., which you can export to directly. Simply click the location you want to export to and follow the prompts. Overall, Camtasia is going to be the only one of these two programs that you can both record your screen and edit your video in, saving you precious work time. With Premiere, you'll have to find another third-party screen recorder before bringing your footage into the editor. One of Camtasia's biggest strengths, though, is that it's the right tool for specific jobs like creating tutorials, how-to guides, training videos, and more. It's literally designed to make these tasks as easy as possible while producing professional quality results. Both have great options for effects, animations, and the like, but Premiere Pro caters to those with vast technical knowledge, whereas Camtasia has an easier-to-understand layout for non-professional video editors. And don't get me wrong, Premiere's a wonderful video editing tool. But if you want to record your screen, edit a video, or show someone how to do something, Camtasia has everything you need all in one piece of software. Jump in and get started, no pro skills necessary. And that's it. Tell us in the comments which software you're going to use and why. If you enjoyed this video, give it a like, and if you haven't already, subscribe to our channel for more great content. Thanks for watching.